Hello, this is Dirk Colbury. Today I'm going to talk to you about how to use the software we installed in previous sessions to write a submission script, copy it over to the High Performance Computing Center, and submit the file. The first program we're going to use is Notepad. I'll just double click on it. And I'm going to just close this file. And I'm going to create a new one. The first line will be the bash line that indicates to the operating system what shell we're using. And then I'm going to do some PBS, which is our scheduler command. So this one joins the output and error file, so I only get one file. I got to specify what resources I need. That's an L, not a 1. And I'm going to say I'm going to run for only about a minute. I'm going to use one node with only one CPU on that node. And I don't need much memory. I'm going to use 500 megabytes. And that's pretty good. The first command, I'm just going to cd to the directory I started in. So this is pbs original work dir, all caps. And then I'm going to run my command. Just for fun, we'll just echo hello world, which will print a hello world to our output file. I'll echo a blank line, and then I'm going to also print some statistics about how long this program ran. So qstat-f pbs job id, and that's good enough. So now I save the file. I'm going to save it to my documents, and we're going to call this file hello.qsub. We're done with Notepad. Let's copy the file over to the HPC using WinSCP. We log in to the HPCC. I type in my password. And on the left, we can see the hello.qsub file. And on the right is my home directory. So all I have to do is drag and drop the file I want. And that was it. So I can close WinSCP if I want to. Now we're going to use our SSH program called Putty to log into the High Performance Computing Center. And we can see our program by typing cat hello.qsub, and there's the program we typed. If everything looks good, we can qsub that file, which will return our job ID number. This qsubbing a file will put the job submission script into the scheduler, and the scheduler, once it finds the resources, the scheduler will run the job. And when the job is finished, the output will be placed in the directory we ran the qsub command in. So we can see if a job is running by using the qstat command and the job ID number. Oop. There's no job I need name that, but if I do an ls, yep, the job is not there because it already finished. And so here's the output for that job, which is the first part of the file is the file name we used for a submission script, and the second part is the job output. There's only one file because we joined the output in the error files. We can see what that file has in it by typing hello.qsub and the job ID. And there is the hello world that got echoed. There's the space that got echoed next to the hello world. And then this is the qstat command that showed us how much, what we asked for and how many resources were used. So that's it. We have now made a program using Notepad++ on our Windows computer, saved the file to our My Documents directory, copied the file to our home directory on the high performance computing system using WinSCP, logged on to the HPCC using Putty, and then submitted the submission script to the queue using the QSub command.